Mamata Banerjee is up in arms against the government of India. She has insulted the Prime Minister by walking out of the conference convened by him to discuss the cyclone in West Bengal. She has refused to send the Chief Secretary to the centre, even though the centre has ordered him to report there. The Indian civil service is being used as a pawn in the game of chess between the state and the centre. Mamata Banerjee seems to be bent on creating a state within a state. High-handedness for obtaining one's objectiveness is called in Hindi Dadagri. Here, Mamata Banerjee, popularly known as Didi, is unleashing a Didigri in Indian federalism. Should the civil service buckle under the pressure of the political masters of the state, or should the Indian administrative services, IAS, IPS and the other civil services hold their independence? This is the mode of question now asked even in the streets of India. Issue has reached a boiling point. Here is Dr. C.V. Anandabose, IAS, renowned national policy strategist, on the issue from Delhi.
Of the Holy Roman Empire, it is said, it was neither holy nor Roman, nor was it an empire. Sardar Patel said, about the Indian civil service, that it was neither Indian, nor civil, nor imbued with any spirit of service. Addressing the All India Service Officers in the training school Metcalfe House, New Delhi, on 21st of April, 1947, Patel underscored the true role of national services. The essence of this national service will be manifest when it seeps into the psyche of every officer that I belong not to the east or the west or the north or the south. I belong to the whole of India, and the whole of India belongs to me. The national character of the top civil services has faced many challenges in the evolutionary process of the federal system. When the central government recruits the officers and lends their services to the state governments, there is essentially a give and take. We should not degenerate into a free-for-all both ways. There are checks and balances which come through the rules, regulations, customs, precedents and propriety. The state and the center are expected to follow the rules and go hand in hand in making federalism work. Whenever there is a dispute or difference of opinion between the two levers of the federation, the rule of law should step in. In the matter of All India Service Officers on deputation from the states to the Government of India, Section 6 of the All India Service Rules 1954 is the ultimate guideline. The rule clearly states that deputation of an All India Service Officer to the centre should be made with the concurrence of the centre and the state. In case of a disagreement between the two, the decision of the centre will prevail. The present impasse in Bengal is not just a question of interpreting the rule book. It's a heady cocktail made up of political chicanery, defiant ego, and an archaic obstinacy, my state, right or wrong. The political animosity which the Bengal Chief Minister has with the centre is no more a palace secret. Mamata Banerjee refusing to participate in the conference convened by the Prime Minister is an act of orchestrated offence and insult, very much in bad taste, as perceived by all right-thinking men. But she is a politician who can go by the rules of politics, whatever that means. But a civil servant has a different set of rules to follow. The Chief Secretary of Bengal, Sri Alapan Bandopadhyay, has placed himself in the dock. He has realized at a heavy price that a civil service cannot hunt with the hound and run with the hare. To place facts in the proper perspective, the chief secretary was given an extension of 3 months by the appointments committee of the cabinet, which has the prime minister and the home minister in it. A question that is asked by many is, why then should he be asked to report to the center? Apparently a high-handed act. This is where one should read between the lines and not just the lines. The chief secretary was hand in glove with the chief minister in the execution of her political agenda, which seeks to deface and defile the federal sanctity and propriety. On the balance of considerations, it is the same ACC which decided to engage him in the center. Obviously, the state government disagreed with it. In such circumstances, the law clearly states that the center's decision shall prevail. A noteworthy aspect is that resignation from service or retirement does not absolve an All India Service officer of his responsibility under the conduct rules. Disciplinary action can be taken against him during the 4 years following his retirement. On a reality check, the role of the Union Government initiating action against the Bengal Chief Secretary appears to be sound and fury, signifying nothing. Governance has more to it than meets the eye. Officers posted to the states cannot play the role of Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. They should know how to avoid the political rat trap. Yes, the bureaucrat trap. In the light of rules, propriety, or federal sanctity, the Bengal Chief Secretary has placed himself in a very awkward situation by design or default. There is a lesson to all the civil servants in this imbroglio. Look before you leap. Keep off party politics. The wile and guile of the political concoction will only toxify the civil service. During the reign of Mrs. Gandhi, the concept of committed civil service was a moot point in national politics, but a civil society nipped it in the bud. All India Service officers, please remind yourselves on and off that you are expected to be neutral, impartial, and objective. Once that is lost, why should there be a professional civil service at all? The political executive can play that role as well. After all, in democracy, political executive is the ultimate, not the bureaucrats. Bureaucrats better draw the line. There is a Lakshman Rekha in public administration. Never ever cross it. It is the Indian bureaucracy, is the Indian bureaucracy slipping into that sullen state again? Does it augur well for the service that the top bureaucrat who should implement the Disaster Management Act is emerging as a disaster itself? Moral of the story, never act without an act and rule without rules. Thank you.